Mr. Lalonde, why is the world so caught up with the SDGs? They seem to be the new buzzword in the development in the environmental sectors.
It's because it's the main outcome of the Rio conference. You know, these big conferences, it was a very difficult one, and the result is, you know, sort of like water which is not too hot, not too cold, not much. But there is suddenly these SDGs, which was unexpected. It was not at all planned beforehand. And it was a proposal during the negotiations coming from Colombia. And everybody was excited by this idea. And why is it so exciting? It's exciting because it's for the first time, it's not only combating poverty, for instance, in developing countries. It's really, oh, but be careful. We also have problems for the whole of humankind. And so probably the last 20 years have shown that in some countries, we know how to lift people out of poverty. Now we are perhaps heading to a middle class of 7 billion people in 20 years or something like that. How is this middle class going to live, going to move, going to produce, going to consume? Sustainable development goals for the whole of humankind. Let's try and think of that. So it's very exciting, very challenging, intellectually first. Can we do that? Is it possible to resume the whole situation in intense goals and politically, can we negotiate that? So that's why everybody's talking about it, because everybody's excited, interested, and is willing to work, because it's going to shape the landscape of international cooperation in the next 20 years.
Post 2015, the SDGs take over from the MDGs. So is it an acceptance of the fact that the MDGs are a failure?
No, not at all. Actually, it's the contrary. It's because this idea of setting goals was decided in 2000 on combating poverty, essentially, with some things missing. And people saw that having goals concentrates, focuses, galvanizes people. And each country, even though these goals were you know, for the global, each country made a point to integrate them in their own policies, in national policies. So building on that, the idea of setting goals for the whole of humankind came after. Now, is it going to be merged with the Millennium Development Goals? We don't know yet. Perhaps we'll have two sets of goals. We don't know yet. I mean, you know, people say it's going to be easier to have one set of goals, so poverty will be integrated in all of these goals. But it's not absolutely sure yet. You know, people are going to discuss. Perhaps we're going to go, because poverty remains an overarching priority in the United Nations. We have to lift people out of poverty. Otherwise, it's not possible. To get to sustainability, but we have to do it in a sustainable way. Okay, so how do we merge that? How do we do that? That's why everybody is working, talking. You know, it's different teams. The people who are working on combating poverty are not the same as the people who are working on sustainability. So how can they work together? I mean, you know, lots of challenges.
But tell me, you know, when the West talks about sustainable development, or when they start speaking about the middle classes, it gives an impression to people in the developing countries that sustainable development is taking precedence over eradication of poverty. Do you think these fears are true?
No. I mean, there is the overwhelming majority of negotiators in the United Nations, and the overwhelming majority of countries, which are most of them developing countries, don't forget that eradication of poverty is the main and overarching priority. But they know that you have to do it in a sustainable way. And I mean, you mustn't oppose both. I mean, but what's interesting also that for the first time, eradicating poverty is taking care of the bottom billion. But can the top billion also make some efforts also to reduce its footprint and to leave things for everybody? You know, I mean, that sort of discussion is coming together. We're all in one world, so how can we do? You know, everybody has to make an effort also, and so the top billion has to perhaps consume a bit better.
Mr. Lalonde, we believe that you have been a regular at the DSDS. So how has the agenda changed over the course of your participation?
Well, it's become a must, I would say, for everybody who's taking care of development and environment, both sustainability and eradicating poverty. It's a must to come here, because this is where, you know, you learn about the experiences, this is where you meet people doing the same thing. So I've seen, you know, the growing of the DSDS, which was in another place, which is going to change the premise next year. It's growing. So this is a good thing. It's very interesting. You know, it's the other Davos. The, you know, perhaps soon we'll say that Davos is the other DSDS. You know, so we don't know.
Thank you for being with OneWorld, Mr. Lalonde. Really appreciate.
Thank you so much.